Hello all, I'm Shilpa Pimpalkar, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Computer Engineering at AISMS Institute of Information Technology, Pune. I welcome you all for the session of demonstration of parser generation using YAG tool. Today we'll see how to use this YAG tool, Bison tool, with Chrome. Let's understand what is this tool. YAG is yet another compiler. It is a tool available as command which helps you to generate a parser. It will allow you to produce a parser based on given specification. You can give specification in .y file and based on specification it generates a parser. Parser will be LALR parser which is generated, and this parser can parse or syntactically analyze the language given as a source code. Steps: how this YAG tool works. As we have discussed, you need to give specification in .y file. You'll give it with YAG command. It generates y.tab.c, and you need to compile this C code. It generates executable. So parser is generated in the form of C program which you need to compile. These are steps for using YAG tool for generating parser. YAG specification will give in .y file. It will generate y.tab.c. You need to compile it. It generates executable. Now let's understand what is format of this .y file. It is in three sections: declaration, rule section, and procedure section. In declaration, you can give inclusion of header files, declaration of variables. In rule section, you can specify grammar and action associated with this grammar. This grammar is for arithmetic expression, like expression plus a number, expression minus number, and expression itself derives number. So it will work for 4 plus 4, 4 minus 4, like that expression. If it is included in source code, it is going to do evaluation of it. $$, $1, $3, these are a grammar symbols. These are built-in variables of YAG tool, which represents value of this particular grammar symbol. And this is subroutine part where user defined procedure or by default yvaref, yvaerror or main method you can declare here. Let's see demo of how to use this YAG tool. See, if you have Fedora or Ubuntu installed on your machine, it will be YAG tool will be available as command. But if you don't have it available, you can use Ubuntu Playground. Cuttokoda site provides you Ubuntu Playground where you can use Bison, you can install it and you can run. Let's see how it works. In my previous session, I explained you Lakes tool. You will need Lakes tool for using YAG tool because this parser generates grammar based on source code. Here token stream you need to pass to the parser. Since parsing is second phase of your compiler, it expects tokens. If you remember phases of compiler, first phase is lexical analysis, second is parser. Source code directly you are giving as input to lexical analyzer. It generates token and tokens are passed as input to parser. So you need to understand first lex and then combination of lex and YAG will give you output of parser. Let's see demo of this YAG tool. Here you can use Ubuntu Playground which is available with Cuttokoda. Now I've used this. Open this. I'll give here command sudo apt install flex. Since this is runtime environment, it supports you execution of this lexical analyzer and parser with tools like Flex and Bison you can use here. So it is a really useful playground if you don't have that type of operating system. We are waiting for the message of completion of this installation of Flex tool. Once it completes, I'll show you demonstration of how to execute command for installing Bison. Okay, so once it will get installed, what we are going to demonstrate or execute here, calculator code I'm going to show you. It is still installing. Okay. We are waiting that it will be completed, and then I can demonstrate you how to create files. We'll see demonstration with calculator. For given a number, it will do arithmetic operation. Like, it depends on which grammar you are specifying for arithmetic expression. Like, you want to do calculator like functionality, you can specify that. Okay, it is completed. Now we will give command flex sudo apt install bison. This is required for parser. Now both files are available. Now what we'll do, we'll create first lexical analyzer and then we'll create a parser. This is sample.l file where I'm going to recognize number. I'm going to create this file as l file where it will recognize a number, and then I'll create a .y file where it will recognize this as number and will print its value. So let's create first vi sample.l. I'm using here vi editor. Let's check with flex command, flex sample.l. You can see here this lex.yy.c is generated. Now what we'll do, sample.y will be created. Sample.y. You can see here with ls command, these different files are created. Lex.yy.c is for lexical analyzer. Sample.tab.c is for parser. Sample.y and sample.l are our input files, lex specification and yank specification. Sample.tab.h is a header file. I'll show you cat sample.l. You'll find here. We have used this file, sample.tab.h. It includes declaration of this token. We are using here number as a token. Lexical analyzer is recognizing this particular pattern. If this pattern found, it generates token. And this token we have used in sample.y file, where if this particular token is found, then it will reduce by using this production and it will display this value. Now let's see with cc command lex.yy.c. And other one is sample.tab.c. Now we can give ./a.out. If I'm giving number 4, it is giving me number found 4. How it is coming? It is giving in parser number found, right? So my input is first passed to lexical analyzer and then it is passed to the parser. So this is simple demo where I've demonstrated you how to write file for lexical analyzer and write specification for generating parser.